in New York City, the prevalence of asthma varies dramatically between neighborhoods. We're conducting the New York City Neighborhood Asthma and Allergy Study, which is an NIH-funded study, to examine environmental risks that could be causing these differences in asthma prevalence between neighborhoods. There's also been an increase in asthma globally, but in the United States also, over the past 40 or 50 years, and we're not really sure why asthma has increased. But because asthma varies so much between neighborhoods in New York City is an ideal location to try and understand why asthma has increased, and specifically why neighborhoods like East Harlem and West Harlem, Washington Heights, have such a high asthma prevalence as compared to other neighborhoods. So we bring dust samples that we collect from the home back to the laboratory. We weigh the dust samples to see how much dust we've collected. We then sieve the dust samples to get rid of the large particles. We extract those dust samples in a saltwater solution. That solution is then put into an assay to measure different proteins that are allergens, so that people might be allergic to, so cockroach, dust mite, mouse proteins. Those are put into ELISA plates, microtiter plates, and through a series of steps of adding different reagents, we're able to then detect how much of these proteins are in each sample. So we know how much mouse allergen, how much cockroach allergen is in those samples. And that's determined at the end of the day by a change in color for each one of those samples. So the bigger the change in color, the more of the allergen we have in the sample. For the air samples, we bring back the pumps. We disconnect the sampling device and we send the filter to the Earth Institute, who measures the black carbon, which is a surrogate for combustion byproducts like diesel exhaust and fuel oil. For the breath samples we collect from the children, we collect those in a balloon, and we bring the balloons back to the lab and we measure a gas called nitric oxide with a nitric oxide analyzer. For the blood samples, we bring the blood samples back, we centrifuge them to remove the cells, and with the component called the serum, we measure antibodies to things that people might be allergic to see if they're allergic to the dust mites or cockroach or mouse allergens that we're measuring in their dust samples. We've demonstrated that cockroach allergen is higher in the high asthma prevalence neighborhood homes, that the kids that live in the higher asthma prevalence neighborhood homes are more likely to be allergic to cockroach, and if they're allergic to cockroach, they're more likely to have asthma. So it seems like we're demonstrating all of those steps along the path from exposure to development of asthma, and that is, in New York City, could be related to exposure to cockroach allergen. The idea is to then reduce the burden of asthma on, specifically on those communities, but on where the asthma prevalence is highest, but on all communities in New York City.